Doncs gràcies a tothom per la feina feta i a continuació intervindrà la senyora Anna Pangopoulou, directora per innovació de l'àrea europea de recerca.
Good afternoon to everybody. I hope you can hear me and see me. My name is Anna Panakopoulou. I'm director in the European Commission responsible for European research area and innovation. And I'm extremely happy to be with you today to this very important session. And listening to the beginning of the session, I would like just to pass my congratulations to the network of Four Motors for Europe for the excellent work that was done so far and in the different domains, in particular in the domain for research and innovation. I found this session that was organized today, it's an extremely important period that is organized. And I'm saying that because it is the moment that universities are developing and transforming towards the future. And research and innovation are indispensable elements for this transformation. A key element of the process of strengthening universities in Europe is to foster the cooperation at all levels, regional, national, and at European level. And I think the example of your collaboration could be, an example that could be communicated across Europe. And it is an example on which we can base our future development, policy development. So certainly we believe that regional collaboration is in the middle of the transformation that we aim to do in the context of higher education institutions. We need universities to be actors for change, to lead change and innovation in this new digital decade, and to be part of the solutions of the Green Deal and the new industrial strategy. Therefore, I appreciate very much the possibility of being with you today to allow me to underline the importance of work done by regions such as yours to foster interregional and intra-regional cooperation and the exchange of experiences and best practices between regions and their respective universities. We believe in the European Commission that this kind of work and more generally the regional support of research and innovation sector are not only beneficial but essential for the growth and excellent performance of universities and the surrounding ecosystems. You spoke a lot about the links to the society. We believe that this is the way to go ahead. You all know about the pilot of the European Universities Initiative, which has been developed exactly to foster the collaboration among universities in Europe. Through this collaboration and cooperation, the European University Alliances are expected to grow together to achieve higher levels of quality and deliveries, to better respond to societal challenges, and to become more competitive internationally. And we think that all missions of universities, education, research, innovation, and service to society have to be seen in a unitary way. You said that already at the beginning of the session. This is also what has been clearly emphasized by the European University Alliances and by stakeholders more in general. As you know, the European University Alliances have been financed and supported by the Erasmus Plus. It's a concept that has been developed in the context of the Erasmus Plus. But because we believe that we have to look at all the missions of universities, under Horizon 2020 program, we provided complementary funding to 39 out of the 41 European Universities Alliances, 17 on the first calls of Horizon 2020 and 24 on the second call, in order to pursue institutional changes in specific research and innovation dimensions. The unique feature of the alliances is that they are doing this together, cooperating and competing together, creating more critical mass together to better solve societal challenges. The alliances represent an excellent testbed for cooperation between universities and for synergies between education and research. They involve, however, just 5% of higher education institutions in Europe. Therefore, we believe more needs to be done to empower the entire spectrum of European universities to transform towards the future, of course, in full respect of the diversity and institutional autonomy of universities. This is why the Commission is currently developing with stakeholders and with member states a new European strategy for universities, which will further empower the European higher education institutions in their transformations towards the future. In this exercise, again, I repeat, we pay attention that all the missions of universities, education, research, innovation, and service to society are seen in a unitary and complementary way. But this is not the first time that we'll try to address the transformation of universities through this communication. This is done on the basis of two very important political documents that the Commission adopted at the same time on the 30th of September of 2022. It's a new policy on the European research area, the single market for researchers and knowledge, and the European educational area communications. Both of them were adopted last year, but also we have a very important Council conclusions on the new European research area that adopted in last December. And in all these documents, there is an urgent call for synergies between European research area and higher education related elements of the European educational area. This communication is currently under preparation in the European Commission, as I said, with close collaboration with the member states. And the aim is to adopt the communication in January 2022, so that it will be discussed in the context of the first presidency of the Council. We had an extensive consultation with the member states, with EU institutions and stakeholders. And our vision is that the higher education institutions of the future will need to be more interconnected, innovative, open, inclusive, and digital, while moving towards a greener and sustainable development. The universities in the future, they have to be able to address in a strengthened manner societal challenges such as global health and climate change. They will need to equip students and researchers with new skills that they are needed to be adapted to our changing environment, working environment, and societal objectives. They will also have to foster exchanges between academia and the industry and the business sector. You said it already. So that knowledge produced in academia can easily circulate and be valorized, feeding the societal high demand for innovative products and solutions. An essential element of this strategy and of the universities of the future will be the cooperation amongst the institutions as well as with other actors of local innovation ecosystem. Work is going to analyze what kind of framework is needed by the higher education institutions to cooperate in the smoothest and easiest way. I would like to have the opportunity to stress in particular one key aspect. There is often a mismatch between the skills and competencies researchers acquire within the academic world and what is necessary for their career development and mobility to the business sector, as well as for the creation of their own startups and businesses. This is why we see as a priority to equip researchers with all the skills that they need to develop in order to develop their careers, offering opportunities for cross-sectorial and interdisciplinary mobility, and also to make their careers more attractive and thus attract and retain the best researchers, while avoiding brain drain and ensuring a balanced and symmetrical flow of talent between member states. On this basis, we have developed the ERA communication, but also the skills agenda that has been established by the Europe. And we believe that with the support of the Council conclusions on research careers that adopted last May, the European Commission is currently going to develop the following activities. First, a taxonomy of researcher skills and occupations, which will be included in the European classification of skills, competence, and occupations, and will also be transposed into national taxonomies. Second, a European competence framework for researchers that will enable researchers to know the skills that they need, self-assess and receive targeted training, while also allowing employers to better understand the variety and high level of competencies researchers can offer. We believe with this approach, with this framework, we'll facilitate job search and intersectoral mobility, thus providing more opportunity for researchers and reducing precariousness. And all these initiatives, it's certainly that will help also the regional development and the regional actors' participation in the context of research and innovation. This initiative of skills and competencies of researchers are complemented by a number of other actions in the context of the European Framework for Research Careers, which will include an evolution of the current charter and code with a more holistic approach in line with the May Council conclusions of research careers, a NERA talent platform representing the successor of your access, offering more services with improved governance, a new initiative, the ERA for You, aiming at strengthening intersectorial mobility of researchers, a reform of the research assessment system to put more focus on impact, quality, collaboration and knowledge sharing than on the number of applications in high impact journals. And last but not least, an observatory of research careers to monitor the impact of measures and propose improvements. We believe that all these initiatives will strengthen the research careers and the attractiveness of Europe as a destination for top researchers, and will then benefit the overall research and innovation dimension in Europe. But what are the future plans that we see to support the research and innovation dimension of the European Universities Initiative? As we said, the European University Alliances are a very important test for development of the universities in the future. Therefore, the Commission is planning to further strengthen them through a full rollout under Erasmus+, that offers more long-term and stable financing. Concerning the research and innovation dimension of the alliances, it must be taken into account that the support from Horizon 2020 arrived slightly later, and implementation is still at the early stage. Therefore, future support for the European Universities Initiative through Horizon Europe depends on the evaluation of the current pilot projects that are supported by Horizon 2020. We expect that this mid-term evaluation of the first 17 alliances is foreseen for mid next year. So we are currently developing all the monitoring methodology indicators based also on the feedback that we have already received from the alliances. Based on the results of this evaluation, we will decide how to proceed from the side of Horizon Europe. What it is important to underline is that our main objective remains to offer a strong framework for universities to perform in the best possible way in all their missions. I would like to finalize my intervention by saying that there are a lot of developments that are ongoing. We have the new strategy on universities very much based on the experience and activities done in the alliances. We have new framework programs in place, Erasmus+, Horizon Europe, with a lot of possibilities for supporting universities. We have the structural funds that they are going to be in place, and they are important instruments that could be used also for supporting the transformation of universities. And also the resilience and recovery facility that we have analyzed from research and innovation, and we have seen that around 35 billion euros are dedicated from the member states on research and innovation actions, including also activities with universities. And last but not least, this new policy that we are going to develop, which is going to pave the way for the universities in the future in Europe, and it is done in a very close co-creation with all of you. So this is where we are. We strongly believe that the regions and the regional development and the place-based ecosystem, they are playing an important role for future research and innovation in Europe. And we believe that the university, an open university in this ecosystem, is a key actor for an excellent research and innovation, a pan-European system across Europe, which will excel at European level, it will excel at regional level, but it will excel worldwide. So thank you very much for your attention, and I wish you a lot of success to the future developments of your region, of your universities in this context.
Ευχαριστώ, Σανά, ευχαριστώ, ευχαριστώ πολύ. Ahora me corresponde presentar lo que han estado las principales conclusiones de los diferentes grupos de discusión. De la sesión 1, internacionalización, la digitalización y la flexibilidad institucional se ha planteado como un elemento clave per avançar en la internacionalització i reduir la petjada ecològica, per exemple, en mobilitats més curtes. Treballar en aquesta direcció i també en l'àmbit de la internacionalització mitjançant metodologies innovadores que faran avançar la internacionalització. Aquestes conclusions marquen un camí cap a fórmules d'internacionalització més profundes que connectin la internacionalització at home amb la mobilitat física en projectes d'aprenentatge col·laboratiu i interdisciplinari. En aquest sentit, el treball de les aliances d'universitats, les existents, amb els exemples del 4 European Union, UNITA, AURA i projectes com SUCTI i SUCTIA, en els quals participen les universitats que avui han estat presents a la taula, sembla que és el camí per a que aquesta internacionalització més profunda que tingui unes finalitats més vinculades a l'impacte social. S'ha de continuar, per altra banda, treballant perquè la internacionalització sigui un procés que, més enllà de la mobilitat dels estudiants i professorat, també contribueixi a la comprensió de la diversitat cultural dels pobles i a la transmissió del coneixement per trobar solucions als problemes del món. Esperem que en el futur les universitats que pertanyen als quatre motors per Europa i també de Gales puguin col·laborar en aquest sentit i que aquesta trobada d'avui hagi estat un pas en aquesta direcció. Sobre la sessió 2, sostenibilitat, the five speakers provided insights into several top challenges related to sustainability, which the institutions they represent identify and address. These challenges include the lack of funding and the lack of awareness, but also the danger of greenwashing, the challenge of being coherent, and the gap between universities and their surrounding ecosystems. Pel que fa a les capacitats, drivers of change are coming from inside and outside the HACE. Need for flexible and interdisciplinary platforms where different cultures and knowledge merge and generate innovation. And third, to activate this platform, there is a need of a challenge-based approach to education with real-life examples to engage students and make the actors of innovation and change in economy and society. Challenge is to make this working also for humanities and soft science. Those are the conclusions. And let me say that well, we finished with a Catalan one. There was a representative of the Catalan University who said we had to focus more much on what, not so much on what that means knowledge, but on why. That's to say, why to follow this path or another one? Why to do the things in this direction? So this reflection also I wanted to point out. So, dono la palabra ahora, para no acabar, a Hans-Georg Wolf. CAP d'Unitat Unió Europea i Cooperació Transfronterera del Departament de Ciència i Recerca i Arts de Baden-Württemberg.
Guten Abend aus Stuttgart und herzlichen Dank für die Gelegenheit zu einem vorletzten Wort aus Baden-Württemberg. Ich möchte sehr gerne aus Sicht des Wissenschaftsministeriums in Baden-Württemberg noch ein paar Eindrücke zu dieser Veranstaltung zusammenfassen. Es ist, glaube ich, klar, dass wir mit sehr großen Herausforderungen zu tun haben und dass nur europäische Antworten helfen können auf diese Herausforderungen. Und deshalb brauchen wir etablierte Netzwerke der Zusammenarbeit, so wie das die vier Methoden seit 33 Jahren sind. Und wir brauchen neue, frische Verbünde, neue Ideen, wie wir sie mit den europäischen Hochschulnetzwerken jetzt bekommen haben. Und ich glaube, es war eine gute Idee, zu versuchen, diese verschiedenen Ansätze zusammenzubringen in einer Veranstaltung. Ich denke, die Veranstaltung hat einige neue Ideen, Impulse hervorgebracht. Manche waren eher disruptiver Natur, manche, sagen wir mal, mehr in Richtung eines graduellen Wandels. Mal sehen, welche von diesen Ideen und neuen Initiativen abheben werden und richtig in die Zukunft starten werden. In jedem Fall konnte das, was wir heute hier gemacht haben, auf virtueller Art nur ein Appetitanreger sein. Und die Diskussion muss weitergehen. Ich persönlich freue mich darauf und ich glaube, wir in Baden-Württemberg, wir in den Hochschulen in Baden-Württemberg, wir alle freuen uns darauf, an diesem Prozess mitzuwirken. Die Aufgaben sind groß, aber wir sehen dem optimistisch entgegen. Und von meiner Seite vielen Dank für die Veranstaltung.
Vielen Dank. Ich erinnere mich an die Parole, Alan Cristina Rizzi, sottosegretario per le relazioni con le delegazioni internazionali del governo di Lombardia.
Io ringrazio tutti i partecipanti, anch'io mi associo con le parole del rappresentante Baden-Württemberg che ha sottolineato l'importanza di stabilire sempre di più delle reti, la necessità fondamentale del confronto che è stato fatto non solo all'interno di questo side event, ma di tutti gli incontri avuti proprio durante la pandemia. E quindi sono molto contento di aver partecipato a quello di oggi, a quello il percorso che abbiamo fatto tutti insieme in questo periodo di pandemia e aver condiviso tutto un percorso confrontandoci su più temi, scambiando informazioni e soprattutto mettendo alla prova i tantissimi ricercatori, operatori, scienziati che operano nei nostri straordinari centri di ricerca. Io ci tengo a sottolineare che oggi abbiamo evidenziato ancora di più la necessità di stabilire questi confronti, di continuare ad incontrarci anche solo virtualmente per scambiare più informazioni possibili e dobbiamo tutti insieme prenderci un impegno. Abbiamo il dovere, abbiamo diciamo anche l'obbligo morale di alzare ogni volta che ci incontriamo il livello, perché grazie solo alla necessità di far confrontare tra tutte le nostre quattro regioni, i nostri migliori ricercatori, operatori del settore, noi possiamo affrontare le sfide del futuro. Quindi dobbiamo alzare il tiro, dobbiamo avere questa finalità, dobbiamo condividerla e dobbiamo sforzarci per andare in questa direzione. È un impegno che dobbiamo assumerci, ma così come ho detto prima è anche un obbligo, rivolto non solo verso le nostre quattro regioni, che sono le più industrializzate d'Europa, ma lo dobbiamo a tutto il continente, alla comunità europea e, consentitemi, anche al mondo intero. Perché solo grazie alle nostre esperienze, grazie alla condivisione di quello che viviamo quotidianamente, noi possiamo cercare di uscire il più velocemente possibile dai momenti difficili e ovviamente anche quello di crescere, grazie all'istruzione, tema affrontato oggi, le nuove generazioni alle sfide del futuro. Quindi grazie di cuore per la sessione di oggi, grazie ai quattro motori per l'Europa e sarà un piacere essere presente durante il prossimo evento.
Muchas gracias. Thank you very much for the participation in that session of the four motors of Europe in the European Week of Regions and Cities 2021 framework. Thanks to all the participants and to all the people who made this sharing work session possible. Thank you, vielen Dank, gracias, merci beaucoup, grazie mille.